When you think about going to the dentist, you might think about things like brushing your teeth and flossing. But did you know there's tons of math involved? Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
My name is Dr. Joel Richards, owner of Westerville Pediatric Dental, meaning I'm a pediatric dentist, which is a specialist in kids.
So how does a dentist use math?
Oh yeah, we use math every day, not just the dentist, but also my dental hygienist and my front desk and managers as well. Pretty much use it with every single patient. Oh, we love using fractions. Actually, every time I do a filling, I use a fraction. So say I'm doing a filling and I use a little bit of numbing sauce, right? The num-num sauce. So that num-num sauce, I'll know if I use one full carb, that's one of the numbing sauce. But I'll see, maybe use a little bit more. I'll put in there that I'm using 1 1/4 or maybe, you know, 1 1/2. So we use that every time, and that lets me know the measurement, how safe we can be, how much we can give that child as well. You know, I look at a child and I, you know, generally know their age, or what we call is when you have a certain amount of teeth, it's called a dentition. So you have the baby teeth dentition, which is called primary teeth, and then the permanent teeth with the permanent dentition. And when you're in between there and you've lost a couple baby teeth and now you have some permanent teeth coming in, it's called the transitionary dentition. So I can look at a child and know, you know, if they're younger than 5 or so, they're probably just gonna have 20 teeth, which is what we would expect. Or if we have about a year, a baby or an infant that's about a year old, you know, they might have anywhere from, you know, 2 to 8 teeth on average. It's just kind of interesting because there's, you know, there's the clinical stuff where we're counting teeth. But I think a lot of people don't know, as a kid's dentist especially, we find missing teeth, extra teeth. And sometimes we call those extra teeth supernumerary teeth, or I like to call them like superpower teeth. And sometimes I've been taking an x-ray, I can kind of estimate when those would come in. So it's kind of cool. So some people have extra teeth that they don't know, and it's very common that it runs in families. So I always ask questions about if it runs in families, you know, did they have superpower teeth too? So I think that's really fun. And sometimes teeth are fused together. So when I count, my number might be off, because those fused teeth that kind of grew together and they kind of are like cuddling a little bit closer, they, you know, now I know the number. So then I would take x-rays to verify those numbers. As time, the most obvious one is we try to schedule our, you know, patients a certain allotted time. So some appointments may take 20 minutes, some kids might need 30 minutes. So we kind of know how to, you know, properly schedule those patients. So throughout the day, you know, we start at 8:30. Our lunches is generally 1 to 2. So then in between and all those times, you know, I'll have many patients, sometimes 10, sometimes 15. I generally know that my hygienist will have about 30 minutes at least to spend with their patients. So generally they will have 15 patients during that day. We actually do the metric system. So we generally measure things in millimeters. So, you know, that's really small. So 1 centimeter is 10 millimeters. We know that, you know, different averages of teeth though, so that's a really, really good question. So when I know like that tooth cavity or sugar bug goes into it, it might go in a millimeter or two. Sometimes it'll be a few more millimeters, and that's how I can kind of guess or approximate how close we are to the nerve of that tooth, because we want to keep that tooth safe and healthy.
Quick questions with a dentist. What was your favorite part of math?
My favorite thing about math? Definitely not the timed tables. Those are always kind of stressful, and I just know some kids are really super fast at them, probably like all you guys, like super good at first. But, you know, maybe doing some word problems and throwing in some words in there.
How do you know what supplies to buy?
I mean, it depends on the month, because sometimes we, you know, the growing, we get more patients that want to come see us and we want to see them. And then we kind of have averages. So we actually can set up those averages with our company. So our representatives, maybe from Oral-B or whoever's supplying our toothbrushes, they'll actually know, okay, you ordered this much this time, maybe we'll order more this time. Yep, we have a spreadsheet on Excel. So by keeping track of all that, we can be very prepared, because you don't want to over or under buy stuff, because then you don't have it when you need it, or you buy too much and then you don't have enough to have lunch that day.
How important is it to be precise?
Oh yeah, measurements to be precise is very critical, especially as a dentist, we're working with, you know, a hard tooth, but we're also working with a live entity of that tooth, which is called the nerve and the blood vessels or the pulp. So when we want to be really precise with something, we need to know exactly how that looks like. So that's why we'll take x-rays. We have seen, you know, millions of these, so then we can kind of look at them and we can kind of see how close are we to that nerve if we're filling a cavity, which is really gentle. And we kind of will know if we have the exact measurement, we know exactly the width of our burrs. So the burrs is that toothbrush piece that goes and cleans out the soft part of the sugar bug. And if it's getting closer and that tooth bug has kind of turned into a dinosaur egg, we might want to get a little closer, might even put a special medicine. So we're going to be very precise. We're actually, believe it or not, in dentists, we can actually kind of measure, even kind of with our eyes a little bit, so the tenth of a millimeter sometimes.
Wow.
We practice that in dental school and we still practice that every day.
Did you enjoy math growing up?
It wasn't my favorite, you know, doing math, but, you know, I'm a science guy for sure. So I always loved science and history. Reading, but you know what, now that I realize it does, I use it every day, like it's kind of phenomenal. It's really, really kind of cool how it helps me provide good care to my patients, you know, setting up appointments, working with my whole team and staff to make the whole appointment safe and fun.
Do you need to show your thinking?
Dentists, especially kids dentists, you know, I work with parents and the child. So I think it's really, really important to be a good teacher. And to be a good teacher, we've got to kind of show things of what we do. So I'm really big on pictures. So I love, you know, when parents maybe have a tooth that got bumped, they can send pictures to me. Well, I also have little forms that I'll show them, and then I'll kind of review that. Same thing when I have x-rays. We don't just say there's cavities there. We want to show you. We want you to understand and see the cavity process. And sometimes they're little baby ones, little shadows. We can maybe monitor them and see what happens over 6 months and then take new x-rays or radiographs is what we call them. But it's really good to be able to look at those x-rays, teach and show and kind of explain the process.
What is your best piece of advice for math students?
I would say, I think repetition. Everything we do, I think in life, I always learn better by repetition. I think someone said that maybe you have to do something 12 times before it becomes good or like a habit or something. But when I want to practice something or be really good, you know, it's repetition. It's doing perfect practice makes perfect.
Challenge problem, dentist edition. Dr. Joel needs to schedule 3 patients. Each appointment takes a half hour. How much time will Dr. Joel need to see all of the patients? Remember, you can pause to take your time and solve. 3 times 1/2. That's the same as 1/2 + 1/2 + 1/2, which equals 3/2 or 1.5 hours. Did you get it correct? Did you use a different strategy? Want more videos involving real-life math and how-to videos for elementary math? Go ahead and like and subscribe. We post new videos every month. Bye! Find out more about Westerville Pediatric Dental and Dr. Joel here.